Hi guys, welcome back. So like mentioned in the introduction, we're going to first model the interior of the building, and after that we'll start with the exterior of the or the skin of the building. This chapter we'll dive into modeling the interior. We're going to start setting up some line work first for all the floor outlines, some important walls and the columns. Let's get started. Let's create some layers for our lines. Let's create a new layer and let's call it 2D. In this layer we'll put all our line work. Now let's create a new sublayer inside the 2D layer and call it 00 or ground floor level. Alright, so what do we need? Okay, we need a layer with the floor slab outlines, so let's create a sublayer in 00 with the name outline and leave the layer color to black. We need a layer for our walls, so let's create one and give it the name walls and let's turn the color to red. Okay, so we need another one for our columns. They're barely visible on the floor slabs, so it will be a little bit guessing when we start drawing those. Ah yes, and let's give it a blue color. Okay, what's next? Ah yes, one for glass and one for the mullions of the glass. Let's give them the glass layer a cyan color and the mullions layer a nice sea green color. These colors are arbitrary, by the way. You can choose them however you please, and you could, if you want to, go with a custom RGB value. Right, so last the one we need is a layer for our stairs and ramps. Let's name this layer stairs and give it a nice dark green color. Alright, that's that. Let's start drawing our floor outlines first. Make sure your picture frame of the ground floor layer is turned on. Only that one, and also make sure the layer is locked so we don't accidentally move them. Make your outline layer the active one, and one last thing, make sure your grid layer is also turned on and locked, as we'll try to use the grid wherever we can. Let's draw a big rectangle first, around the whole building. This to separate the outside from the inside. Alright, that will do. Okay, so let's start drawing the boundary of the building on the ground floor. And let's start by drawing a polyline at the top left corner and work our way clockwise around the perimeter until we reach back to our initial start point. You can hold shift to temporarily toggle the orthogonal option in Rhino. Alright. So you can see on the ground floor image, the part here is quite wavy. We'll simplify the floor outline a little, so it will be more like a saw zigzag. We'll use the grid and smart track to standardize the dimensions of this part as much as we can. Okay. So the same goes for the bottom part. I'm using the grid intersection for our bottom right corner. It doesn't exactly match up with the picture frame, but that's okay. I'm using a combination of following the construction grid and the picture frame to draw the bottom zigzag shapes. As you can see, I'm switching the picture frame on and off to draw more clearer. Alright, so almost done. Let's pick this grid intersection first, before we draw this small inclined part. Now let's follow the picture frame to draw the other inclined line pieces, and let's finish the line a little short from the end, as we'll use a chamfer operation. Now let's start a new line, beginning from our initial start point, to the intersection of the grid lines, close to where we left off the other line. Nice. So now let's initiate the chamfer command to finish our shape. Make sure the distance setting is set to 0,0 and the join is set to yes. Now click first on the line we just drew and then near the end of the other line. And if everything went well, you'll see your shape got automatically closed. Cool. Now if you look at some interior photos, you see there's a cool inner patio. Let's also draw those floor outlines. Let's start at the top left corner again and work our way clockwards downward. Don't worry about the curved part. We use a fillet to do that corner. Let's also snap it along the grid lines and use our smart track to finish up the shape. Alright, so now for that corner. Run the fillet command and give it a nice radius of 5 and hit enter to finish up. Cool guys, let's continue with our walls. We're not going to draw that much walls, just the important ones. Let's start with the core on the top right. Let's draw an encompassing rectangle, more or less like this. And let's offset it 50 centimeters. This is going to be the thickness of the walls we're going to use for all our walls. Now let's continue with the auditorium area. Let's start from the top right side and work our way down. Let's use our grid as our guide to start. Ah, and let's start on the inside so we can easily offset it outwards. Let's draw the first corner orthogonal. Later on we'll use the fillet command to create a nice radius. I'll be switching the picture frame on and off again to see if I can use the construction grid in any way. For instance, here we can snap nicely to the construction grid. Now let's draw the line down until we have that kink. Let's also match up this kink with the construction grid intersection. Alright. Next up, make sure your ground floor picture frame is on and simply trace over the walls until we reach the same grid line we started our line with. We need to stop it at the curved part and from there onwards draw a control point curve. All right, nice. Finish the curve with another polyline ending at the same grid line we started our shape with. Don't forget to join the line pieces together when you're done. Now let's select our line and offset it with 50 centimeters outwards again and make sure you're set the settings cap to flat. There's another core on the left side near the entrance. For these walls, we're just going to draw the outline. These lines will work as guide when we'll jump into modeling the skin, as these walls are freeform and they're a part of the skin. Let's start at the top left and draw a straight polyline first. Use the grid intersection as our start point. Stop a little shy of the corner. And now, let's draw the bottom part using a control point curve. Draw it until the left and finish it up with a small straight line piece. Now let's use some fillets to fill in the gaps. It is a little trial and error to get the radius right. Let's use 1 meter for the corner on the left, and let's use 2 meters for the one on the left, on the right. Alright, what's missing? Ah, the columns. Cool. Okay, let's start again from the top left part of the building. Let's pick the intersection of the grid lines here to start drawing our column. Draw a circle with a radius of 50 centimeters again, so the columns will have a diameter of 1 meter. Now let's use this column to copy it over to the other grid intersections. Make sure your intersection snap is turned on. Alright, there's a row of columns in front of the entrance facade. Let's select one of the columns and choose the base point for copying in the center. Okay, so now let's copy them along the facade using the picture frame as a reference. Just those two columns missing. Let's select the column next to them and hold shift to copy them nicely orthogonal. So that was the ground floor. In the next section, we'll continue with the first floor.